Welcome to the planet Tiamor, about 170 light years from Earth, in the year 10,000. 90% of this planet is desert. Now, this is what I wanted to show you. Glass City, one of the most complex cities in this particular galaxy, famous for its exquisite beauty. With so much sand around, the native Sioyomtins, who actually eat sand themselves, decided to experiment with a cheap building material. They make beautiful glass ornaments too. Now, who's thirsty? Let's go get something to drink. Desert shake, please.
Certainly, sir.
So, any events happening here in the near future?
Well, there's been a lot of talk lately about the Vault of Yuga-Nerikun.
The Vault of Yuga-Nerikun? I thought that was just a myth.
Well, it was until recently, but then some pretty good solid evidence was discovered. A document dating back to the time of Yuga-Nerikun was found, describing on which planet the Vault could be found. And that planet happens to be Tiamor.
Interesting. I don't suppose there's any chance that document could have been a hoax.
According to all experts, it's genuine, and now some earthly humans are making a lot of noise about this. And if I know humans correctly, they'll probably go looking for it.
Well, that's humans, will you? Always so inquisitive. So what is this vault? The Vault of Yuga-Nerikun is a legendary place, hidden by the Space Lord Yuga-Nerikun 15,000 years ago. The vault is said to contain riches beyond imagination, including the legendary Orb of Tiamor. What's that? It's an immensely powerful piece of technology that can control the brain of the Eshangayatiatis, the moving desert.
The what?
Eshangayatiatis. Say mythical beasts. Some say they're immortal. And anyone who controls the Eshangayatiatis controls Tiamor. I want that power. And I just so happen to have a device that tells me where unidentified tech is nearby. We must wipe out those alien scum.
Why? Why would you want to do that?
They stand in the way of the third great and bountiful human empire. Our great Omni-Minister, Amlisha Rattle-Thura, says that we humans are the superior beings. All other sentients stand in our way. Hail, Amlisha.
George, I think it's about time we left.
Doctor, could we have a word with you, please, in private? Of course. This is worrying. Amlisha is this century's equivalent of Hitler, started the Eighth Galactic War. And with the Orb of Tiamor, Radan must be stopped.
How?
I'll go with him to the Vault of Yuga-Nerikun and try to reach the Orb before he does. We'll come too. We can help. It's extremely dangerous. But then, I can't do this alone, so... All right, you can come along. But be very, very careful.
Hello! Hi, my name is Dr. John Smith. Emma and George told me that you were looking for the Vault of Yuga-Nerikun, and we'd like to come with you. I take it your friends have changed their minds about Amlisha, then? Of course. We all want to do our duty for the Empire now, don't we? Well, in that case, welcome to the team. I'm Radan Singulin, and these are my friends, Ebod Umguntat and Anim Galai. We leave tomorrow morning. Hail Amlisha! Hail Amlisha! See you tomorrow, then.
How exactly does the legend go? Yuga-Nerikun's vault and the... Eshangayatiatis.
Yuga-Nerikun was the greatest interplanetary explorer of the planet Zar. He went around the universe collecting the most beautiful ornaments and the most powerful technology he could find. Then he buried them in an enormous vault on one of the planets he discovered. And that planet is now thought to be Tiamor. Some new evidence has been found.
And the Eshank thing. The Eshangayatiatis is a huge semi-mythical creature, with a life expectancy of more than 50,000 years, and a frightful appetite for pretty much anything. Its name means the desert moves. Its skin is impervious to most weapons, and it can grow back missing bits, and its body produces a chemical that causes its prey to be too high to defend itself. And according to legend, the Orb of Tiamor affects the Ashank Ayatiatis' brainwaves, and anyone who controls the Ashank Ayatiatis controls the desert, and therefore 90% of this planet. Why have we stopped? What are you doing? Hey! Talk to me!
Ooh. Wow. I mean... Wow. Whoa. Why are my hands so big? What? I mean... What? What do you mean? Your hands are tiny. Isn't it nice, Doctor? Nice.
Wow. Those were some really nice butterflies. I mean really nice. Pretty butterflies.
Come on, Doctor! Let's... dance!
Hey! Everyone! Come to your senses!
What? Shagayatiatis, head for the mountains!
Oh,